Hey, what's up? This is Chris. Have you ever struggled to take better pictures? I have a few tips for you to improve your pictures instantly. These are some really basic skills, but they are overlooked by many photographers. And I guarantee these skills can help you to step up your game in photography. First of all, remember to level all your pictures. We level our pictures in most cases. Some photographers don't level their pictures, but that's a different story because they did it on purpose. I'll talk about it a little bit later. Having your pictures leveled is important across all genres of photography, especially for landscape, because usually we have the horizon in our pictures. If it is tilted, the picture will look weird. We look for a sense of balance when we are capturing landscape, and that's why having a perfect level in your pictures is usually important. As for other genres of photography, it's comparatively more acceptable to have your pictures unstraightened. As we mentioned a little bit earlier, some photographers don't level their pictures on purpose. These pictures are commonly seen in street, portrait, and maybe wedding photography. Let's take a look at this picture. This picture is from one of my clients' wedding. And I leave this picture tilted because of the following reasons. Firstly, I want to put the viewers in the first person perspective because I'm trying to make it look more immersive. At least that's my approach in taking wedding pictures. It also looks like a quick snapshot and it makes the picture look more natural and candid. Secondly, remember to stick to the rule of thirds. You should have heard of the golden ratio, right? Basically, rule of thirds is derived from the golden ratio. It gives you promising results most of the time, and you can probably apply this rule to all genres of photography. Here is a diagram of the rule of thirds. To apply rule of thirds, we can put the subject, let's say a person's head, on one of the intersection points here. Or we can fill the lower one third with the foreground and leave the rest to the background when we are taking landscape pictures. Let's take a look at this landscape photo. The ground fills one third of the picture and the rest of the two thirds is filled by the sky. And I think this is the perfect proportion here. The proportion follows the rule of thirds and we leave sufficient canvas for the sky so the picture looks more spacious. Imagine if we adjust the proportion to 50-50. It will not be as good because we don't want to focus too much on the ground when we are capturing scenery in most cases. I'm not telling you to always stick to rule of thirds, but it is a very good starting point if you are a beginner in photography. When you are more familiar with rule of thirds, you can just maybe mix other composition rules into the rule of thirds. Thirdly, you have to get closer to your subject. The great photojournalist Robert Capa once said, "If your pictures aren't good enough, you are not close enough." There are two advantages when you shoot at a closer distance to your subject. You can get a blurrier background and make your picture look more immersive. We all know lenses with wide aperture can help you to get decent bokeh. But if you are shooting close enough to your subject, even if you are using a kit lens, you can still get some good bokeh. Because aperture is only one factor that affects the bokeh. Your distance to the subject is actually another crucial factor too. A blurry background can help you to separate the subject from the background, and it makes your picture look more professional and appealing. Secondly, shooting closer to the subject can help you make your pictures look more immersive. Sometimes you want the viewers to be on the scene with you, especially if you are doing journalistic photography or wedding photography. I always mention wedding photography because that's my profession. Imagine if you are attending a wedding party, you don't always stay at a distance from the scene, right? So let's take a look at this example. When I took this picture, I get closer to the scene so I can include the crowd as the foreground, so I can tell the story and make the picture look more immersive. It looks like I'm one of the guests in the wedding and I want the viewers to feel the same too. When you get closer, you can bring the audience, the viewers, to the scene. So these are the tips that I would like to share today. Hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't yet. I'm trying to upload 1 to 2 videos per week and stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching and see you guys next time.